In this lecture, we will learn about implementing methods separately in C++ class. Okay, so what it means? Okay, let's understand. So when we declare a class, so we have a class, then the class name like a point. Then what happens is we open a brace and then close a brace. Inside that you write your member data members and member functions, okay? But the thing is, we want that we can easily understand our code, okay? So what we do is that when we make huge, big, large code base, then we separate the header file, which contains the definitions, just the declarations of the data members and the functions, whereas the .cpp file, so it has all the implementation of the member functions, okay? So this way your header file has just enough information so that you can understand what the class does. So for example, as taking the vector.h class, okay, so we have in that we have a class point declaration, okay? So there we say that, okay, there is a class point. It has two data members, x and y. Then we have void offset, double offset, and double offset y. So it declares that, okay, we have a function, data member function, okay, a member function offset, which takes argument offset x and offset y, both are double, okay? Then we also have a member function print, okay? So this is sufficient to tell that, okay, what the class looks like and what are the member functions and data attributes that you expect from the class. Okay, so similarly, what we can do is we can also declare the vector class. So class vector, so point start and end, so void offset, so we have double offset and double offset y. So this tells that, okay, there is a class vector also, which tells that, okay, it will have a start point and an end point. And you have a member function which will provide offset to it and which will print the information about class. So this is known as the header file. So which, as the name suggests, so its meaning is that you will have the header. Next, let's come to the implementation part. This is the code that will be used, okay, so to know about the class, okay, when you are browsing the code, you will know about the class, what to expect from it, but you should also need the real CPP file which has the implementation. So how you do the implementation? First, when, because we are defining now the member functions outside the class, so you need to tell, okay, the function belongs to which class. So how you do? Give the class name, like here point, then you give a double colon, okay, which tells that, okay, after this, whatever, so this function name, okay, belongs to this class. So this is the binding between the class name and the function, member function name. So otherwise everything is the same. So we just add this part, point, so scope operator and offset, so double colon. This tells that, okay, this offset function which we are implementing, this is for the point class, okay? And because now the offset, the function name is same for both the vector class and the point class, but this vector scope resolution operator, this tells that, okay, now the offset we are defining, so this is for the vector class. So this is the simple way. So this indicates which class method is being implemented. So this way you see now we are defining the vector.cpp, which defines the, implements the member functions for point class, its functions offset and print, and the vector class and its member functions offset and print. So this is very simple. So now in the main, you can just include vector.h and then you can define the object. So for example, if you do in main that hash include, and then you can do vector.h. So what will happen is now in int main, so you can define the objects of this class. So for example, point p you can define, okay, and then you can also define your vector here, declare an object of type vector, and then you can call the methods like p dot print and similarly v dot print, etc. So I hope you understand this basically differentiating in the separating the header file and the cpp file is for better understanding of the code and in handling much larger code. So thanks a lot.